So ito naman, ano yung resultant nito? Ay, inhanap ba? Wait lang. X component of the resultant. Ah, meron din. Magnitude of the resultant. Yan. So, first natin gagawin is we have to define muna yung mga lengths niya ng force na to saka ito. So, for this force, yan. We can draw a line here. Parallel to the z-axis. Yan. Now, naka-slant yan kasi dito siya tumama. Yan. So, just take that into account. And then, we can extend this line pala. Wait lang. Naka-slant pala siya. Yan. So, for F1, lagay natin X, Y, and Z. Yung component niya along X for this force is ito yung X-axis. Parallel to that is itong side na to, 6 feet. Yan. From this point kasi tumama siya sa corner. So, 6 feet yung distance niya along X. Yan. And then, along Y naman, parallel to this axis, from here, tumama siya dyan at this distance, 3 feet lang, parallel to the Y axis. So, this is 3. And then, along the Z axis, from here up to the bottom, we have 4 plus 3, magiging 7. Yan. And then, for F2 naman, this force, along X, nakaslant din yan siya. Nakaslant. So, meron siyang components along X, Y, and Z. Now, along X, it has a distance of still 6 kasi from here, tumama siya sa corner. Yan. Ito yung distance niya along X. And then, along Y naman, from this point, yan, tumama siya dyan. So, along Y, still 3 plus 3 na. Kasi yung buong distance niya yung na-cover. So, 6 feet along the y-axis. Yan. And then, along the z-axis, ito, F2, tumama siya dyan, for which the height parallel to the z-axis is only 3 feet. So, 3 dapat yan. So, masosolve na natin yung lengths niya. So, the length is for the first one, square root of 6 squared plus 3 squared plus 7 squared. And then, for F2 naman, 6 squared plus 6 squared plus 3 squared. Yan. So, check down natin yung values. 6 squared plus 3 squared plus 7 squared. We have square root of 94. And then, ito naman, dalawang 6 squared plus 3 squared. So, magiging 9. Feet. Yan. So, we can now get the component along Z, along X, and along Y din. Magnitude of the resultant. So, gagawin natin is, ano ba to? Resultant, compute the angle between, compute the X component din. So, let's sum up forces along X. Yan. So, yung assumption ko dito is, ano na lang, still, positive yung pa-forward. So, pa-forward, ito yung plus pala. Ito naman, for y, yung patungo sa right. And then, for the z-axis, positive yung pa-upward. So, let's sum up forces along x. We have, puro negative yan kasi pointing sila sa negative direction. So, minus. And then, ito yung gagawin natin. Yung force 1 is 900. So, multiply natin siya by the distance along x, which is 6, divided by the length. So, square root of 94. Yan. And then, for the other force naman, 700. So, minus 700. And then, multiplied by the x component, still 6. But, the length is now 9. So, divided by 9. So, ito lang. So, minus 900 times 6 over square root of 94 minus 700 times, wait lang. Yan, times 6 over 9. We have minus 1023.63. This is pounds. And then, summation of forces along y naman. Lahat ng directions nila are pointing to toward the positive y direction. So, plus lang lahat. So, we have here 900 multiplied by the y component, which is 3 for F1, divided by square root of 94. And then, plus 700 multiplied by the y component, 6, divided by 9. So, input natin, positive na yan. This is 3. And this is also plus. So, magiging 745.15. Yan. And then, for the summation of forces along z naman, lahat ng directions nila are pointing up. So, plus lang din lahat. So, we have 900 multiplied by the z component, 7 for F1, so 7 over square root of 94 plus 700 multiplied by 3 divided by 9. Yan. So, papalitan na lang natin to. This is now 7. Well, this is 3. So, 883.13. Yan. So, yung resultant pala is square root of 1023.63 squared plus 745.15 squared plus 883.13 squared. Yan. So, equal yan to square root of unsquared plus 1023.63 squared plus 745.15 squared. So, 1543.69. Yan. So, ito na yung resultant natin. So, ito pala. 1544. Letter D. And then, the angle between the resultant and the x-axis, you must account the sign. Naka-negative kasi yan. So, use negative also. So, cos phi x is negative 1023.63 divided by the resultant, which is 1543.69. So phi x is ano yan? Minus 1023.63 divided by 1543.69. I mean, r cosine pala. Sorry. Shift cosine. Yan. So, 131.54. So, yung sagot natin is ito pala, letter E. So, be careful dito kasi sa books kasi yung convention niya is yung pa-forward na axis always yung positive. Now, if gagawin mo yung positive, lalabas din siya sa choices. 48.47. But, hindi yan yung sagot. So, be careful lang talaga. Yan. And then, calculate the x component of the resultant. Ito na yan. Yung summation ng forces along x is 1023.6. So, box din natin. This is approximately 1024. Yan. Ito, letter A.